x minus a power m into x minus b power n in the interval a b where m and n are positive integers. Write down. If we expand these equations by using binomial expansion, binomial theorem, and taking the product of these, then we get the polynomial of degree m plus n. Write down next. Therefore, fx is a polynomial. Fx is polynomial of degree m plus n, and every polynomial function is continuous and differentiable. Clear? Therefore, continuous in closed interval AB and differentiable in open interval AB. Now, f of A and f of B. A minus A, 0. A minus A is 0. So, 0 into something is 0. Next is f of B. B minus A power m. B minus B is 0 here. 0 into something is 0. So, f of A is equals to f of B. Now, there exists C belongs to AB such that f dash C equals to 0. Now, first find f dash x by applying u into v rule. First function, derivative of second plus second as it is, derivative of first. Take x minus a power m minus 1 and x minus b power n minus 1 common. Here we have left with n into x minus a plus m into x minus b. Yehi bacha hamare paas. Kyunki yahan pe hamare paas power m hai. एक पावर इसमें से सब्ट्रैक्ट करेंगे तो एक पावर ऐड भी करनी पड़ेगी. सिमिलरली हियर यहां पे पावर n है, इसमें से एक पावर सब्ट्रैक्ट करी तो एक ऐड भी करनी होगी. सो वी हैव लेफ्ट विद f dash x as x minus a पावर m minus 1, x minus b पावर n minus 1. ओपन दीस ब्रैकेट्स, nx plus mx. सो m plus nx minus an minus bm. Take minus common, an plus bm. Now, f dash c is c minus a, m minus 1, c minus b, n minus 1, m plus n into c minus an plus bm. Clear up to here? Now, f dash c is equals to 0. Now, these three terms are in product. These three terms will be equal to 0 if either of these three terms is equal to 0. Either c minus a is equals to 0, c minus b is equals to 0, and m plus n into c is equals to an plus bm. That is, c is equals to bm plus an upon m plus n. Now, c is equals to a, c is equal to b. ये तो फंक्शन की वैल्यू है ही क्लोज इंटरवल में. नाउ वी हैव टू चेक फॉर दैट वैल्यू ऑफ सी. अगर हम इसको देखें सी की वैल्यू को, बी एम प्लस ए एन एम प्लस एन, इट इज डिवाइडिंग ए बी इंटू रेशियो एम रेशियो एन. क्लियर? इट इज डिवाइडिंग ए बी इंटू एम रेशियो एन. दिस इज डिवाइडिंग इट इन द रेशियो एम रेशियो एन. It means C lies between A and B somewhere. Therefore, C is equals to BM plus AN upon M plus N belongs to closed interval AB. Therefore, Rolle's theorem is verified. Is it clear to everyone? Let's go to next question now. Next question, question number 7. verify Rolle's theorem for the function f of x is square root of 4 minus x square in minus 2, 2, 2. Now, अगर हम इस function को देखें, minus 2 और 2 के बीच की किसी की value के लिए ये function defined होगा, और f of minus 2 will be 0, f of 2 will be 0, and f of minus 2 and 2, अगर हम इसकी limits देखें, write down, fx is defined for all x belongs to minus 2 to 2 and has a unique value और हर एक point के लिए इसके पास unique value होगी इस function की. So at each point of this,
b into
into A plus B into B. Again log of 1 is equals to 0. F of A is equals to F of B. Therefore there exists C belongs to AB such that F dash C equals to 0. Clear? Now take the derivative of this function. F dash X. Derivative of log is 1 upon X. Derivative of X square is 2X. AB is constant. So its derivative is 0. This term is constant. So its derivative is 0. Take the LCM. X, X square plus AB. 2X square minus X square minus AB. So X square minus AB. X, X square plus AB. Clear? Now F dash C is equals to 0. So F dash C is C square minus AB. C, C square plus AB. When this term goes on right hand side, it becomes 0. So we have left with this term. C square is AB. It means C is square root of AB. Now square root of AB lies between A and B. C is equals to square root of AB lies between A and B. Let's take any example. If A is 1, B is 2. Then square root of 1 into 2, 2. That is square root of 2 is 1.414. That lies between 1 and 2. It means square root of AB lies between A and B. Therefore, the Rolle's theorem is verified. Now the next one is, verify the Rolle's theorem for the following functions. First part is fx is equals to sine square x, 0 is less than x, less than equals to pi. Now since sine x is continuous and differentiable everywhere, sine x is continuous and differentiable everywhere, we can write f of x as sine x into sine x, that is sine x square, sine square x, product of two continuous and differentiable function is also continuous and differentiable. We can write f of x as sine x into sine x. We can write it as this. Therefore, product of two continuous function is also continuous and differentiable. Therefore, f of x is continuous on closed interval 0 to pi. Fx is differentiable in open interval 0 to pi. Now, f of 0, sine 0 is 0. F of pi, sine pi is also 0. So f of 0 is equals to f of pi. Therefore there exists C belongs to AB such that f dash C is equals to 0. Now f of x is sine square x. Derivative of this f dash x, 2 sine x. Derivative of sine is cos x. We can write it as sine 2x. Now f dash c is equals to 0. Sine 2c is equals to 0. Sine 0 is also 0. So c is 0. Clear? C is 0. Or sine pi is also 0. Sine pi is also 0. So c is pi by 2. 0 point to jo hai wo interval ka hi hai. Now pi by 2, c is equals to pi by 2 belongs to 0 to pi. Therefore, the Rolle's theorem is verified. Now the second part is,
solve 5 square 25, 8
देन टू जीरोस लगाई हमने अपनी तरफ से, देन पॉइंट, फाइव को टू से मल्टीप्लाई किया, टेन। अब हमने जो डिजिट इसके पीछे लगाना है वही डिजिट यहां आएगा, मल्टीप्लाई इट बाय फोर। मल्टीप्लाई इट बाय फोर वी गेट दिस टर्म, बट वी वॉन्ट द टर्म लेस देन 800, लेट इट बी 7। सो 749। Now multiply this digit by 2, 57 into 2, 114, 10 minus 9, 9 minus 4, again double zero here. Now 114 के पीछे जो digit आएगा, वही digit यहां पे आएगा. Let it be 4. That is 4576 and so on up to 2 or 3 decimal places we can find. So we get 1 plus minus 5.74 upon 8. So this value for cos this lies between the given function 1 plus minus root 33 by 8 belongs to 0 to pi. This value for angle cos lies between this. Therefore, the Rolle's theorem is verified.